I have been waiting for this day for about 3 weeks now, ever since people started announcing that two of my favorite bands on this channel at this very moment came out with fucking singles. Both of them came out with new singles. What a perfect setup! An absolute perfect setup between these two giants for me. And I have to say, in round one, Caligula's Horse, The Hands That Hurt the Most, was a little bit above Haken, just a little bit, just beat him on that first round. I still am listening to The Hands That Hurt the Most. I think it's better than Dream the Dead, the more I listen to it. After I listened to it the first time, I was like, man, maybe it was just like one of those first like songs that appear and is like really good chords that just kind of caught me up in the emotion of the moment, but maybe it wouldn't be that powerful the more times I listened to it. Nope, now I'm not saying that I cry every time I listen to The Hands That Hurt the Most, but I will say the same kind of emotion is invoked in me. Like every time I listen to it, I'm just like, damn, this is such a good song. Oh, this is such a good song. I think it might be my favorite song out of all these bands, out of everything at the moment, with Dream the Dead, I mean, literally right next to it. So those are my two favorite songs for sure. And again, Haken as a band is, I mean, it is neck and neck between Haken and Caligula's Horse for me on this channel. So what better way to go to round number two with these new singles? Now again, some of this is like a little bit unfair because, you know, in the first one, the songs were quite different in nature, so it wasn't like a complete good comparison between the two. Although, I would say Caligula's Horse song, The Hands That Hurt the Most, was, you know, pretty standard for what Caligula's Horse has done so far that I've listened to. But the Haken song was a little bit different for sure than the typical Haken song that I hear. So we'll see what this is like. Maybe there'll be a bigger advantage to Haken this time, or maybe it'll be a bigger advantage to Caligula's Horse again. I don't know. I'm going to have to listen to both of them, but still, this is going to be a good battle between the two of them. And because I listened to Caligula's Horse first last time, we're just going to trade off, and the first song we're going to do is Prosthetic by Haken. So let's get to it. I cannot fucking wait. Let's go. Yes. Oh, oh, oh. Oh, nice. Is this fucking with sugar? Heavy as fuck. Oh, I like that. Do it again. Nice. Subdivisions. Nice fucking fills. Fucking fills. There's some alliteration for you. Dude, this is starting out amazingly. Ooh. Ooh, I like that. Like how they're all following that, like syncopation. And the music matches the lyrics so far. This is fucking on par. I don't wanna talk about it anymore. So sick of chorus was good, but not epic. Dude, this is some sick technicality going on. This is wicked. Marshash? What the hell is that? Nice. Yeah. This is definitely going to the gym with me tomorrow. I don't wanna talk about it. This has got like a punk rock feel. Chorus part, or is this the chorus? Oh, they're nice. Ooh. Nice subdivision, break it in half. Balls to the wall. Songs I've heard in a long time. Oh, it sounded like that. It sounded like Honor Thy Father kind of. I realized that I was cussing a lot. And like, this is just a side note, but cussing can be praiseworthy. Like, bad words, when there are bad words. I'm like, uh-oh, I might get like flagged for this because I'm cussing so much, but it's praising what they're doing. I'm not being like angry at somebody. This is like, you know, if you see an amazing situation that's just miraculous or just beyond your senses, sometimes the best word to describe that is holy shit. It's like holy shit. It like takes the word, transforms it into a phrase. It's like oh my God is not good enough. It's like this, you got to use the F word. So it's like, I was like, oh man, I'm cussing a lot because it was, that has got to be the heaviest, sickest song that I've heard in a long time. That beats out any of those metal bands, like the heavy guys. That was just amazing. That was freaking awesome. Wow, I'm literally shocked at how good that was, and the sound was so powerful. Now granted, I turned up my speakers a little bit in my ears, so I was probably yelling into the microphone, because I couldn't even hear myself, but it was exactly what I look for in a powerful, just ram it down your throat kind of song. And the man, it was concise, it had a repetition enough, but not too much repetition. It went off into different areas a little bit, especially with the drums that were going on in the back. Wow, that was, I mean, the only thing I think I can complain, and I wouldn't even call it a complaining, is just I don't feel like the chorus was as good as it could have been. And again, this is coming from my preference. I think that, like, I like the melodic, genty, whatever you want to call it, kind of melodic, uplifting choruses. And I was looking for, I think it'd be beautiful kind of distinction between that heaviness and then his angelic voice. I was waiting for his angelic voice to come with like some beautiful kind of natural chords in the chorus, but that didn't happen, which that's such a small piece. I would rate the song a freaking 9, and I never give 9s. I never give 9s. That song was a 9. That was, just like I said in the first video between these two, I'm like, after I heard Caligula's Horse, I was like, Haken fans, you're going to have a tough time beating this. I am now telling you, Caligula's Horse fans, you're going to have a tough time beating this. I mean, this was balls to the wall. I cannot wait to listen to this in the gym. This is going on the playlist for sure. Wow. I'm definitely dumbfounded by this song. This is great news coming for the new album. This makes me want to listen to the new album, like, straight through. So, moving on now to Caligula's Horse. The thing I'm a little bit worried about with this is that I said in the last reaction, now after listening to three Caligula's Horse songs, they kind of have the same song in all three songs. It's very in the same kind of framework, and I love it. It's like obviously my favorite band with Haken right now, but I'm a little worried and concerned that is this all they're going to be? Because if like every song sounds like Dream the Dead or The Hands That Hurt the Most, it's gonna get old. And I can be like, well, I'll just listen to Dream Dead and The Hand That Hurts the Most over and over again. I don't need to listen to these other songs that basically are the same replication of those two great songs. So I'm hoping that this being a new album, that this has some sort of a different kind of sound from Caligula's Horse as well. Not just, but even if it does have the same genty, whatever, melodic chords and like same kind of organization, I'm still gonna love it, but I'm definitely not gonna probably be as hyped because it sounds similar to the things that I've already listened to. So let's find out. Are you ready, Caligula's Horse? Can you do it? Can you dethrone this song? I don't know how you beat Prosthetic. This was awesome, but it's round two. Here we go. Caligula's Horse.
When the moment comes to light the lust in its eyes on you, leaving us no legacy but residue, it's when you preach your promises like the filth was always there, like we were always.
Shit, is this gonna get blocked because it's the official video? Got another heavy one. This is a good match, maybe. Ooh, I like that, like, rhythm. Ooh. Slower tempo. I love slower tempo. Trying down the creek gives way just to buy just another one. The morning like a that trash is awesome. Ooh, I liked how it knees with that beat. There's their... This was kind of what I was looking for in the Prosthetic song. See, there's that beautiful voice. Ooh, like, they are so good at that. Psh. Nice. Man, both of these bands are just technically killer.
So give us something more than the wretch, than the pose of the penitent. And with the rapture rack, spit back the impact in the god.
and they're really good at the stops. Nice, picking it up, see?
Isn't this what you want?
Man, subdivision's right on. Back to the where's that? Say your empty prayers.
Keep your eyes full and listen. Your sons are all singing Maria.
Maria. It's pretty heavy.
And you can plead your promises and lead your covenant. But can't you hear it? They're already singing Maria.
And they're doing a great job of going back and forth a lot between the subdivisions. It's not just once or twice, it's like every four measures they're going back. I like how it's kind of faded in the background. And it's, ooh, pushed forward. That's great engineering right there. I fucking love these two bands. I love these two bands. How's the outro gonna be? This is a great outro. Ooh. Got me a little welled up again. Oh. Holy crap. The ending got me a little welled up just like that last like 30 seconds. Oh my gosh, man. I don't even know how this is freaking possible. I just don't know how this is possible. Okay. This kind of worked out perfectly because I would say these songs are very much similar, except obviously the prosthetic is a little bit heavier, like more driving. But I mean, this song also had the like very like rough riff. And oh, okay, I think I know. I think I know how to break this down. It kind of just worked out perfectly like this. My complaint with the prosthetic song was that the chorus was missing kind of that like good melodic uplifting in between the heavy crusher skull. And I wish it had that. And if there was any negative to that song, that would have been it. This song, overall, generally speaking, was good. It was better, I think, than Prosthetic overall as a general whole. But this song had an amazing chorus. Everything that I was talking about should have been in the last chorus. Listen to it. I mean, it's almost like if you could have taken this chorus and put it into Prosthetic, it would have been perfect. But I have to give it to Prosthetic as far as the heavy part that was not the chorus was definitely better than this verse part. Even though I liked the riffs in this, they weren't as powerful. They weren't as like hit you in the mouth. They were great rhythmically. I loved it. I said a lot of the syncopation, which was also done in Prosthetic, but it wasn't as like, wasn't as just like, ah, oh, yeah, the energy flow in the verse. So to me, okay, this is the best way I'm going to describe it. I've been living in Korea for 9 years. And this will, for those of you who haven't not heard this, I think I said this in another video a long time ago, but I'm going to say it again because I think this will be a perfect analogy. So when I came to Korea, I remember and living in Korea this whole 9 years, this is what I think of Korean women. If I were to be walking around Korea, just anywhere in Korea, specifically in Seoul, I guess more so, walking around in Seoul, 25 million people in Seoul, dwarfs New York, and I just kind of like go like this and just go like that, 9 out of 10 are gonna be bangable. 9 out of 10 are really cute. Like, they're cute. Wow, they're cute. If I go to the United States and I go like this, 9 out of 10, I'm gonna be like, I'm trying to be mean, but they're just, yeah, 9 out of 10, I'm not gonna be very excited or attracted to. However, this is the difference between Korea and American women for me. Even though in Korea, almost all the girls are just kind of cute and really cute and passable, dateable, whatever you want to call it, they're just kind of like sevens everywhere. I never see like a 9 or a 10 Korean girl. Even the K-pop girls, outside of the TV, I literally have seen K-pop girls walking on the street and I was like, huh, really? I see those girls walking down everywhere all the time. Look, there's another one, there's another one. They look just as good as those K-pop girls in real life. They're just very, very much a seven. But in the United States, even though most girls are just very unattractive to me, when you do find that attractive girl, she's like a 9 or a 10. She's freaking hot. It's like, wow. You are beautiful. I can even give you some examples if you're looking for them on Instagram. And so this is kind of the best way I can describe this song. Is it's like the Caligula's horse song, Slow Violence, was like a 7 or 8. It was an 8 overall. So generally, it was better than, I think, Prosthetic, generally overall. But Prosthetic, in its strong part, was so good and so high that I have to give it to Prosthetic as just, again, it's so close, but it's a little bit better. I just have to give it to him. And I'm not just doing this to be like, oh, see, I gotta make him so it's more interesting in the video. No, I'm being 100% real, yo. I have to give it to Prosthetic, and that's how I feel, but just a little bit, because that those heavy chords and that drive and that song was just amazing. But on the flip side, Caligula's Horse, this song wasn't very connected to Dream the Dead or The Hand That Hurts the Most. It was a different enough that I was like, good, and it still had the elements of Caligula's Horse that at the end literally made me well up again. That's like the second time, 2 out of 4 songs. So half the time I listen to Caligula's Horse, I'm freaking welling up with tears. I can't believe it. I'm shocked. So I don't know what else to say. I want to hear what you guys say in the comments. Which one did you guys think, especially you Caligula's Horse fans and Haken fans, if you're a fan of both of them, who edged it out for you? I just gave you my opinion. In the comments, please, please tell me what you think, because I'm very interested in debating, because maybe you could change my mind, but this is how I feel right now. So as always, like and subscribe, and remember, I just came out with a new video that's a little bit different in content, so go check that out. I'll put a card up here for you throughout this video. All right, peace out.